This video serves as a short introduction to our latest paper, Reef Benthos of Seychelles, a Field Identification Guide. The guide is now openly available on the PenSoft Biodiversity Data Journal website and has been released as an open access paper. Seychelles and Necton partnered on a 50-day at sea expedition that visited Seychelles' outer island and explored its shallow and deeper reefs. The survey we undertook started at 10 meters of depth and went all the way down to 350 meters of depth. The team of international scientists on board, including many Seychellois scientists, surveyed these reefs using scuba diving gear, ROVs and submersibles. These were equipped with stereo video camera systems, filming the benthic communities at each depth and each location. The field guide contains information for 184 different distinct benthic morphotypes. They are sorted into their distinct classes, for example hard and soft coral, echinoderms, algae and invertebrates. And each of them comes with a short description and a couple of images that essentially would make it possible for someone to identify the organism as seen from their own video footage or as seen live in the field. To many people's surprise, the most diverse group were actually the sponges, and we discovered many different sponge species around Aldabra Atoll, especially in the shallower waters, which came in all shapes and sizes and even colors.
The green seaweeds were the most abundant, particularly the genus Halimeda, which had 4 to 5 morphotypes. Seaweeds are often overlooked in reef studies when they are food and habitat for numerous species. As a consequence, the overall knowledge about seaweeds is very limited. There are very few guidebooks, particularly in the Indian Ocean or in the Seychelles, where, besides their ecological importance, seaweeds could represent a new opportunity for the blue economy.
There has not been any research work undertaken in the mesophotic habitat across the Seychelles CBZ, and moreover, there's a lack of marine species identification guide, especially in deeper reef areas where diving is not possible. So this new ID guide, which focuses on benthic flora and fauna, provides not only an overview of the organism that is present in our water, but also makes available key taxonomic information and images as well to facilitate species identification in future research work, for example. And I do hope that this ID guide will be much utilized by researchers in future research work.
Our field guide should not be seen as a full catalogue of the life of Seychelles' deeper reefs. We made sure to categorize and describe every single individual that we recorded. However, there are certainly many more species out there just waiting to be discovered, described, and of course in dire need for protection.